Here are some quick troubleshooting tips for your head tracker. The first recourse if the head tracker isn't behaving properly is to go to the troubleshooting menu. You can find us on Bridgehead by clicking somewhere on the button grid, then holding down Control and clicking on the lifebelt icon when it appears. Troubleshooting mode actually locks Bridgehead, so it stays connected to your head tracker whether it receives data or not. Usually if there's a prolonged period of silence, it will disconnect and reconnect over and over again until the head tracker responds. The first problem you might encounter is that the animated head may be replaced with the word bootloader. This can happen if a firmware update fails for whatever reason. You can get the unit working again usually by clicking Reinstall Firmware and disconnecting and reconnecting the head tracker. When it reconnects, you'll be offered a firmware upgrade, which of course you should accept. If you have a tick, you can click that to disconnect and reconnect. Otherwise, you'll have to shut the troubleshooting window and unplug and plug the unit in again. Accept the firmware when you're offered it and things should soon be back to normal. The next common problem is that the thing may go into a cycle of disconnecting and reconnecting automatically. This tends to indicate that the head tracker isn't actually sending data to Bridgehead. Have a look at the raw data in the troubleshooting panel. This tells you what the six sensors in the head tracker are actually doing. If you give the head tracker a bit of a shake, you should notice that all six windows show data. All this data should update at the same speed. If some are stuck or frozen, you've got a faulty sensor on your unit and you should get in touch with me. The second thing is that you have reddish, greenish and bluish components in these windows. If the windows lack any of these, again you have a fault. I've only seen that kind of fault once in about 100 units, but build errors are possible. The next common problem is a slow drift of head position off to one side, so that after a few minutes, the head finds itself at a peculiar angle. This can happen if the gyroscope calibration needs to be set up. This may happen during the head tracker's lifetime, but you shouldn't have to play with this very often. It is important that the unit is kept perfectly still for this, so put the head tracker somewhere where it isn't going to move and press the button. When it lights up again, the calibration is done. This third button, well, that's just in case something happens with your firmware. If you're experiencing a problem that all the above advice doesn't solve, as a last resort you can try clicking bootloader reboot and reconnecting the unit. When it's in bootloader mode, it doesn't work as a head tracker, but you do have this kamikaze option here. Click that and all the calibration settings will permanently vanish. Unplug the unit, plug it in again, and it may just work, but you will have to calibrate the gyroscope and compass again.